You know, maybe the other group has a point. Maybe vapes do get people away from cigarettes. But maybe not. I wasn't originally going to say this, but my dad, who's a doctor, he used to smoke also. He switched to vaping. You see, the problem is it's not about the people who used to smoke and switched. And you guys said it's a cessation device. You have all those stacks of paper. I actually only need two. That's the FDA official cessation product. You'll see vaping's not up there. There are three main problems with vaping. One, there's a lack of education about what's in it. Two, vaping is a gateway. Nicotine gets people addicted for the rest of their life. And three, vaping is targeted to kids. Not people who smoke, but kids. Luckily, some smart people in Washington came up with a solution. And that's House Bill 2144. You see, House Bill 2144 would put a 95% wholesale tax on vapes, just as is on all other tobacco products that vapes are already categorized with. And actually, this wouldn't be hurting the vaping community. This would be helping the vaping community. You see, it would actually give money to regulate vaping. It would give money to educate people about the dangers of vaping. And thirdly, it would give money to raise the price just slightly from 1/4 of the price of smoking to 1/3 of the price of smoking so that youth who are more price sensitive are less likely to buy it. It is imperative that we pass House Bill 2144 to regulate and educate the people of Washington about the dangers of vaping, especially among youth, and to prevent this epidemic from spreading.
As Miles just explained, one of the biggest issues with the e-cigarette industry is the lack of education. People don't know exactly what e-cigarettes are, and more importantly, they don't know what's in them. Even the name vaping, it implies that it's just water vapor, which it most definitely is not. According to the Lawrence Berkeley National Lab, there are 31 proven kind of harmful chemicals emitted by vapes. Of those 31 harmful chemicals, at least 9 are proven carcinogens. At least 9 cancer-causing chemicals are present in the emission of vapes. I'm going to go over a few of those. First one being cadmium. Does anyone know what cadmium's in? No? It's in batteries. Next, formaldehyde. Anyone know what this is used for? It's used to preserve dead bodies. Toluene. I'll save you guys the effort. It's actually a paint thinner. Each of these chemicals are extremely dangerous, but perhaps the most important for us to talk about is the nicotine. Not only is nicotine itself a carcinogen, but it's also extremely addictive. The U.S. Surgeon General even claimed that nicotine is as addictive as heroin. This is extremely important, especially when we're talking about teen and adolescent use. The National Health Association claimed that 8th graders are twice as likely to try e-cigarettes today than traditional cigarettes. On top of that, the UW School of Public Health came out with a statistic that those teens that try e-cigarettes first are 20 to 30% more likely to try traditional cigarettes afterward. So what's kind of causing this? How are they getting a hold of these products? All of it's in the marketing. These products are completely marketed to kids. E-cigarette companies are taking advantage of the fact that there's not a lot of regulation, that it's not regulated at the same level of traditional tobacco products. By fruit flavors that are extremely attractive to children and young people. This is actually a tactic that traditional cigarette companies used until 2009, when it was outlawed with the Tobacco Control Act. On top of that, advertising and sponsorship campaigns by e-cig companies are completely aimed towards kids. E-cigarette companies claim that their target market is longtime smokers who are looking to switch to an alternative. Just take a look at this Juul advertisement. It features a young, cool-looking girl, lots of bright colors. It looks super fun, super cool. Maybe something I'd even try if I didn't know any better. The bottom line is, these advertisements are geared towards kids. E-cigarettes are not safe. E-cigarettes are not healthy. And e-cigarettes currently are not being used as an alternative to traditional smoking.
This is why, as Maya said, House Bill 2144 is the solution to the issue of e-cigarettes. This House Bill proposes to tax e-cigarettes at the same standards as the tobacco industry, so at a 95% wholesale tax. And how will the tax help? Well, first of all, it will help to fund regulation for four main causes, which is healthcare services, the training of healthcare professionals, tobacco, vapor products, and nicotine prevention and education, and the Cannabis and Liquor Board. However, this is not it. It will also help fund education campaigns, which have already proven to be very effective in reducing the number of people who consume tobacco. In fact, the Truth Campaign, which is a national campaign which was directed to preventing youth from smoking, was directly responsible from keeping 450,000 teens from starting to smoke in the first 4 years of the campaign. And not only that, but it also managed to save up to $5.4 billion in healthcare costs. And finally, this bill will also reduce the number of people who vape. It has been proven that taxation is the most effective way of reducing tobacco consumption. Studies carried out by the Institute of Health and Prevention for Policy have shown that for every 10% increase in the real price of tobacco, there is a reduction of 3.5 youth who stop smoking.
We get it. You vape. But we aren't arguing that vaping should be illegal. We aren't arguing that e-cigarettes should be illegal. We're arguing that they should be regulated. You know, it wasn't until 1969 that the first nationally implemented tax on cigarettes came to the United States. That's over a century after the first cigarette was commercially produced. Today, the Center for Disease Control in the United States claims that over 480,000 people die every single year as a direct result of cigarette smoking. We don't want this to happen again. We do not want history to repeat itself. The bottom line is simple. These cigarettes are dangerous. They're dangerous because their ingredients are unmonitored. When people choose to use these products, they don't know what they're putting in their body. But House Bill 2144 will regulate them. It will force manufacturers to disclose exactly what they're putting in their products, so people will finally know what they're consuming. E-cigarettes are dangerous because they're extremely addictive. People are trying these products one time and finding themselves hooked for life. But House Bill 2144 will fund education. This education will allow people to make informed decisions before they try these products for the first time, and will also eliminate the misinformation that these are healthy alternatives to cigarettes. And most importantly, e-cigarettes are dangerous because they're targeted at children, promoting that they go down an unhealthy and regretful path. But House Bill 2144, House Bill 2144 is going to increase the price of cigarettes, e-cigarettes. It will make it drastically more difficult for children to get a hold of them. At the end of the day, regulating e-cigarettes by passing House Bill 2144 is a necessity, because it will save lives.